The city's on fire.
I'm sure Goots is fine. He'll be making for the square.
The one with the bell tower. In the middle of town, right?
Guard, watchman, or sentry is to be slain on sight.
But spare the citizenry. His Highness's orders were clear.
Those were Imperial Dragoons. What in the hell is going on?
Let's go and see.
Right. First, we find Goots.
Just hope he's all right.
You there! Identify yourself! Into a sewer.
Evacuation is complete, Captain. throne of Rhaenyra.
There it is. The bell tower.
Right. Let's go. Goods left.
Where in Grigor's name did you come from?
Get him!
Thank you.
enemies on the ramparts!
Kill them, get them!
Can you see him anywhere?
Thank you.
slow.
Over here, Clive! Are you all right?
Goats, there you are.
I didn't know there'd be a dragon.
All right, let's get out of here.
Oh!
What now?
Is that Mother Crystal's heart?
What the hell is it doing up there? The helmet.
This.
We must leave. Now, Your Grace, I beg of you.
This is not what he wanted. Something's happened. Forgive me, Yut, but I must put a stop to this.
Your Grace!
So, what do we do now, then?
We destroy the heart.
But he might come back!
As soon as the flames die down, the Imperials and the Dalmex will move in.
This may be our only chance.
And Bahamut has gone for now. You should get as far away as you can, Goots.
What? And leave you slot in the ledge?
I can't do that. If you're staying, then so am I. I packed everything up before I made a run for it, so if there's out you need, just ask. But I won't be giving it away for free. Nana'd never forgive us if I did.
Thank you, Goot.
Just let me get my stuff out. Whatever yous need, leave it to me. Did I do it right? That's 10 times better than it was before.
You be brave now, boy.
Do yous need out? Welcome to Goots's Toll. Is there out else you need? Righto, here you go. You've got everything you need, then.
Drake's tail is right there, Clive. It's time to free Storm from the Crystal's curse.
Oh, it's past time. But remember, Bahamut is still out there.
And I dare say we'll be seeing him again before the night is done. No more roads.
We'll have to find our own path.
Do you feel that, Clive?
Ether. Just what we need. Another flood.
It's already turned.
There's no reason to hold back.
Come on.
climb up. Are those the council chambers? How are they still standing?
I don't know.
He'll be all right, Clive. He's a survivor.
We're getting close. Like somebody doesn't want us getting any closer.
I don't care what it wants.
Neither do I.
Yeah!
These beasts, they're getting stronger.
We can think about them later. Right now, there's only one thing we need to focus on.
The heart.
We might be able to get up through the building.
It's worth a try.
Someone up there.
Is someone there?
Mother.
It's you.
What happened here?
He tried to take him from me. Oh, my boy. My darling. Darling boy.
Is this the child you made with the Emperor? Why, Mother? Why did you betray us all?
You have no right!
Answer him.
We took you in, savage. Show some respect for those who raised you. Honorable Elwyn. Always thinking of his precious homeland. But what worth is a homeland in a world beset by the Blight?
Father did not seek to protect his country. He sought to protect his people.
A leader's duty is not to protect his people. It is to protect the source of his sovereignty. The noble blood that runs in his family's veins. So long as this bloodline remains unbroken, what does it matter if a nation falls? One can always found another. Unlike him, I did my duty. I preserved my line. I bore a son of the noblest blood, to whom the whole world might kneel. That is why I gave Rosaria to Sambrek, that I might join my line with the Lesages and birth a savior of this benighted land, blessed by both Bahamut and the Phoenix!
You sold your country for a child.
Why did he need another? You had Joshua.
I had nothing. You were always your father's son, so very strong and bold and daring. And yet you failed to awaken. Would that Joshua had been granted a tenth of your strength. Oh! How the nobles laughed that Elwyn's firstborn was surely the son of a concubine, and my own, not long for this world. The shame of it, the shame of being slandered by one's inferiors. How could you ever know how that feels? It should have been you! Why didn't the Phoenix choose you?
Joshua's every waking moment was spent trying to shoulder the burden that you and the Phoenix and the Duchy foisted on him. That's why I became his shield. To help bear the weight. But what did you do? You betrayed your own blood and surrendered your son to his fate!
Joshua, my darling boy. I never meant to hurt him. The soldiers' orders were clear. He was to be spared. Why did you survive when the only one I truly cared for died?
What? Have you not looked out of the window? Joshua is here! The Phoenix lives on! He's battling Bahamut as we speak! Joshua! Wake up! I am a shield of Rosaria. And I will do my duty.
What are you...
Thank you. yet.
Thank the Founder!
Thank you.
This is drinking me.
We have to stop him. Joshua!
Joshua! Clive!
My brother.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You're alive. We both are. Nothing else matters. I never dared hope that I would see this day.
Reunited at last.
Jill!
It is done. The demon that would tear our house apart is no more. Father.
The Mother Crystal. It's collapsing.
Right. We need to leave.
No. Wait. I owe him a debt.
Fine.
Can nothing be done to call them off?
I regret not, Your Radiance. The Dragoons answer to none but His Imperial Highness. The Council is powerless to intervene.
What madness is this, Theon? Focus all efforts on extinguishing the fires around the capital. City can wait.
Don't dally, man! Go!
Your Radiance!
By the light! Dion, have you taken leave of your senses? Call off the Dragoons at once!
Fear not. The populace will come to no harm at their hands. I am here to save you, Father.
Save me?
A creeping darkness hides in the heart of Sanbrek. It stems from your wife, the traitorous Annabella.
Not another word, Dion.
Father, though you may not see it, the darkness has taken hold of you. It has made you forget yourself. But I bid you remember, there was a time when you ruled not with cruelty, but with compassion. Why now do you turn your back on your people? Why now do you seek to stoke the fires of war? You too have borne witness to this change, Your Eminences. And you know, as well as I, who is responsible for it. A puppet now sits upon the throne. But cut his strings, and the Master loses the power!
What?
Dion, you bear steel before your Emperor?
Guards! Take him!
For every citizen who falls, another can be bred. For every home that burns, another can be built. Those were your words. But when the last of your citizens has fallen, and all of their homes have been reduced to ash, what will become of your empire, of its rulers, of your god? As the Mother Crystals crumble one by one, and the Blight sweeps in to claim all that we hold dear, our people look to their Emperor for protection. Yet he labors not to secure their futures, but to seize what is left of the Twins for himself! Even if it should come at the cost of everything his loyal citizens have labored to build!
Dion, you must understand.
A small price to pay, is it not? You've been blessed with great power, Dion. Enough to win me the world. So go, claim Valestia for me, brother.
Dion.
superb.
Poor father. How he doted on his children. That he would die to protect me was plain. It was but a matter of when.
You planned this?
You did well to endure so long. But you broke in the end, as I knew you would. And now Muthos approaches. Put him to the proof. I would see if he breaks. Go, Bahamut. Kinslayer.
You cannot stay here, Mother. Come. Take my hand.
Get away from me! This is all just a dream, just a bad dream! You will not take me, Shadow! You will not take me!
Mother.
Consciousness that weaves your wills together. Consciousness that blurs the boundary between your own will and that of others. Then we shall set you apart once more. The ties that bind you shall be severed, and humanity return to its proper place. Primogenesis shall a new age of reason begin.
How is your brother?
asleep since our return from the Dominion. Tyr says he should be back on his feet soon enough. For a while, at least. She discovered something on his chest. A swelling, circled in stone.
The curse. For every mountain we climb, another rises up to greet us, doesn't it?
It's never ending. Even the sky seems to have grown tired of it all. If I disturb Joshua, while he rests, I might as well see what Otto has to say.
It will take time to come to terms with everything that happened in the Dominion. But time is the one thing we always seem to lack. It will take time to come to terms with everything that happened in the Dominion. But time is the one thing we always seem to lack.
I do say so myself. No scratches, right?
Did you see that? Tell me you saw that.
What are you making them skies then?
Otto, how fares the realm?
The realm? Oh, she's just fine. As long as you look past the fat storms at Mother Crystals and her skies are a roiling cesspit.
And Gav?
He's with your uncle in the Free Cities, helping Mid with her project. Sent an owl their way the moment the winds turned foul. Still waiting on a reply, though.
Do you have any good news?
Well, that depends on your definition of good.
All right, fine. What do you suggest we do?
Oh, no, I'm just the messenger. I'll leave the scheme into those more suited to the task. Could be that Lady Vivian and Old Tomes have their own thoughts on the current state of things. Could be that they don't. It certainly can't hurt to ask.
I suppose not.
Thank you.
How is it that every one of your little excursions presages some inexplicable catastrophe? Not that you are to blame for the Dominion's fate. No one could have predicted the actions of the Crown Prince.
I'm sorry I couldn't save your home.
My countrymen are stronger than you think. A few toppled clock towers won't break their spirits. They'll be back on their feet in no time.
I hope so.
Look at us. Bluer than a pair of bog crabs. Tempting though it may be, sulking will not help us find a solution to this mess.
You believe there's one to be found?
I don't know. But I am certain we're more likely to find it if we first examine the facts.
Beneath these darkened skies, fear and confusion reign over Valisthea. Oh, the lands around the fallen Mother Crystals had already begun to wilt for want of ether. But not like this. Crystals that filled wells and fueled furnaces, now nothing but pretty shards of rock. And those that hang from the people's necks cast nary a glimmer of light to keep the dark at bay. It is only a matter of time before the common folk convince themselves that the end of days is upon us. Yet I fear a swift end is more than we can hope for. While most of the world thirsts for ether, the remainder drowns in it, spawning Akashic in droves. And amidst the hordes of mindless beasts, with magics as like to fail as function, even the strongest nation would falter. Rosaria and the Iron Kingdom teeter on the brink of collapse, while the tragedy in Twinside has all but paralyzed the Holy Empire. Dalmechia fares little better. Rumor has it the ministers fled the capital after the fall of Drake's Fang, leaving their beloved republic to crumble. Walud, meanwhile, moves in earnest. The Einherjar has been sighted off Storm. The world, in short, is in chaos. It would seem our civilization was nothing but a castle of sand, to be washed away at the whim of the waves.
A castle of sand.
Not my best flourish, but it seemed fitting. The reports I've received are considerably more blunt in their appraisal. Without the protection of their nations, it will fall to the people to defend themselves against those who would take what is theirs.
Which is only ever going to end one way.
Defending a farmhouse against a band of chocobo thieves is one thing, but pitchforks and palisades will do little to stall an army's advance. Should the King of Walud deign to invade, there would be none to stop him.
None but us.